Exponential growth and decline is governed by the function n as a function of t equals n sub naught times e to the kt power. Now note the n as a function of t. It almost looks like n times t. It's not n times t, it's n as a function of t. Just like f as a function of x. We could have f of x instead of n of t in there if we were using x instead of t. The n sub naught is just a variable that stands for the initial amount. That little zero there means initial. So n initial, or what we're starting with. K is a constant, and we can determine that with data. And t is our variable for time, and it's the units of time used for the particular application. If the growth rate is per year, then t is in years. If it's per day, then t is in days. In this example, we're going to look at a population that grows exponentially, 3% per year. If the population is initially 1,000, how many years will it take for the population to double to 2,000? Also, how many years will it take for the population to go from 1,000 to 4,000? We're going to use the model n as a function of t equals n sub naught times e to the kt. In this case, n sub naught is 1,000. So we can replace n sub naught with 1,000. Also, we know that n as a function of t equals 2,000, and we want to find the value of t that gives us that, so we're going to plug in 2,000 for n as a function of t and get 2,000 equals 1,000 e. Now we also know what k is. K is the constant that is the growth rate, in this case 3% per year. Well, we write 3% as 0.03, so we replace k with 0.03 and we get 2,000 equals 1,000 times e to the 0.03 t power. In the second question, our n as a function of t is 4,000, so we let 4,000 equal the initial amount 1,000 times e to that 0.03 times t power. And we can solve both of those by using our methods for solving exponential equations, and that is to get the exponential by itself. So in the first case, we divide both sides of the equation by 1,000, and we get the simplified equation 2 equals e to the 0.03 t power. We take natural log of both sides, and we get ln of 2 equals ln of e to the 0.03 t power. Now our property of exponents allows us to move the 0.03 t exponent out in front. We also know that natural log of e equals 1, because natural log is base e log, and log base e of e is 1. So we can just drop that ln of e right off. So we have ln of 2 equals 0.03 t times 1, which is just ln of 2 equals 0.03 t. We divide both sides of that equation by 0.03, and we get t equals 23.1 years if we round it. The second question we answer pretty much in the same manner as the first, except we use 4,000 instead of 2,000, and we have 4,000 equals 1,000 times e to the 0.03 t power. We get the exponential by itself by dividing both sides by 1,000, and we get 4 equals e to the 0.03 t power. We log both sides with natural logs. We move the exponent out front to get ln of 4 equals 0.03 t times natural log of e. The natural log of e turns into 1. So then the simplified version is ln of 4 equals 0.03 t, and we divide both sides by 0.03 and find the natural log of 4 on our calculator, and we get t equals 46.2 years. This next example is like the previous example, except in this case we are not given the growth constant. In this case we have to calculate it. a car's value is declining exponentially. The car is currently 3 years old and has a value of $18,000. The car sold for $26,000 brand new. How much will the car be worth 5 years from now? Now we use that model, n as a function of t equals n sub naught times e to the kt. In this case, our initial value is 26,000. We plug that into the model and we get n as a function of t equals 26,000 e to the kt power. Now we're not given k, but we can use the given data to find k. We have that n as a function of 3 years is 18,000. In other words, we can replace n as a function of t with 18,000 and then plug in t equals 3. So we do that. We put in the 18,000 for n as a function of t, and we plug in 3 for t because that's the t value that gives us 18,000. Now we have an exponential equation that we can solve for k. We get the exponential by itself by dividing both sides by 26,000. And that simplifies to 18/26 equals e to the 3k. We then take natural log of both sides. We get natural log of 18/26 equals natural log of e to the 3k. We apply that power rule for logs and we move the 3k exponent out in front. We get 3k times natural log of e equals natural log of 18/26, and natural log of e turns into 1, so we can just leave it off. We get natural log of 18/26 equals 3k. We have to divide both sides by 3 to get k, and we get natural log of 18/26 divided by 3 equals k, and that equals negative 0.1226. Now we can modify our equation. We write n of as a function of t equals 26,000 times e to the negative 0.1226t, because now we know what k is. Now we have a problem just like the previous problem. We want to know what the value of the car will be in 5 years. Well, since the car is already 3 years old, we have to add 5 to 3 to make it 8 years old. So we let t equals 8, not 5, and in our completed model, and we get n as a function of 8 equals 26,000 times e to the negative 0.1226 times 8. And we just have to calculate this on a calculator, raise e to that power, which is the product negative 0.1226 times 8, and then multiply that result by 26,000, and we get a value of 9750 when we round it off. Notice what the k value was really giving you here in this problem. We got k equals negative 0.1226. What that's really telling you is the car is losing 12.26% value each year.